Did you know that the development process for Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts was, cluttered? In fact, the end product scarcely resembled the initial design. Rareware had teased a new Banjo-Kazooie game under the name Banjo 3 ever since the release of Banjo-Tooie on the N64. They even showed off a Banjo-Kazooie GameCube tech demo at Space World 2000. And although they never referred to it as Banjo 3, it was a sure sign that Rare were on track to make a new Banjo-Kazooie game. Now this is where things start to get messy. In September 2002, Rareware was bought by Microsoft. The buyout included all of Rareware's intellectual properties like Banjo and Conker. Multiple Nintendo games were cancelled, and Rare started to work on projects for Microsoft's Xbox. From what we can tell, this included Banjo. Some time ago, the admins of Rareware Central acquired a build of a game labeled Banjo X. It was clear the code was meant to run on the original Xbox, but it was in an unbootable state. Although they couldn't get it to run, they were still able to go through the code and see new Banjo-Kazooie assets like springy shoes, rocket sneakers, metal feathers, aviator goggles, invisibility chocolates, big feathers, bag of eggs, and diamond beak. The build also contained assets from Grabbed by the Ghoulies and Viva Pinata. We know that both games were in development for the Xbox at one point in time, so this makes sense. In a community chat with various people from the Rare fanbase, Greg Mayles, a key developer in the franchise, revealed that Nuts and Bolts was actually the third attempt at creating Banjo 3, and that the earliest idea involved a remake of Banjo-Kazooie that would hit the player with bizarre and unexpected changes. Similar, in fact, to how they remade Conker's Bad Fur Day. One example given was having a giant queen termite burst out of Ticker's Tower in Mumbo's Mountain, forcing Banjo and Kazooie to get Konga to throw oranges at her to win. The next idea was a traditional platformer that would feature Gruntilda following the duo around each world and trying to outdo them at every turn. The early stages of Nuts and Bolts development are so convoluted that it's near impossible to tell which attempt was Banjo X. But there's one thing we can be sure of. In 2004, Rare started work on a game called Banjo-Kazooie. When the name came out, people just thought it was a working title for 2005's Banjo-Pilot. But it was actually a kart racer being developed for Xbox. The game's focus was having the player construct their own vehicle out of different parts and then racing their creations. It didn't get far in development and was quickly shelved. The concept was later implemented in Nuts and Bolts when the developers started to realize that the worlds were getting too big to traverse on foot. This led to the project being entirely reworked with vehicles in mind. The working titles for the game include Banjo-Buildy, Banjo-Kazooie 3, and Banjo 3. All of this suggests that Nuts and Bolts actually started out as Banjo 3, a traditional 3D platformer, just like Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie before it. In case you lost track of all that, here's the rundown. Banjo 3 teased in Banjo-Tooie and the GameCube tech demo, the Microsoft buyout, Banjo X, Banjo-Kazooie, and finally, Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts. Did you know that Banjo-Kazooie started out as a Super Nintendo game developed under the name Project Dream? It focused on a boy named Edison, and Banjo was merely a side character as a generic bear, along with an idiotic dog and rabbit. The game took longer than expected to develop, so Rareware decided to move the game from the Super Nintendo to the Nintendo 64. The main character in the game was changed to the rabbit. In fact, it was changed repeatedly until the role of the main character was given to a bear named Banjo. And not to mention, the storyline got a massive overhaul. Kazooie wasn't planned to have any kind of significance in Project Dream, but she appeared as a baby bird in a nest at her own house. The main villains in the game were a gang of pirates led by Captain Black Eye. Captain Black Eye was actually referenced in Banjo-Kazooie in the Mad Monster Mansion level. His portrait hangs near a treasure chest. He later appeared in a pub in Banjo-Tooie where he repeatedly states, "Once, I had a dream," in reference to Project Dream. He tells of a bear who stole his glory in reference to Banjo taking the spotlight and Black Eye falling into obscurity over the course of Project Dream's development. That's all for today, but we'll be back with more Did You Know Gaming soon, so make sure you subscribe, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and check out more gaming trivia at didyouknowgaming.com.
If you're a fan of Pokemon or The Legend of Zelda, check out the videos in the annotations on screen. And also, it wouldn't hurt to subscribe yourself to JonTron.
Fucking, how many words do you want to write, Shane? Fuck.
He told me you'd do that.
What?
Like, I send him my lines, and I'm like, oh, sorry, I didn't edit them. And he's like, I